seen. Man, not what you say. I never knew it could hurt me so bad. When the power of love is up there, forgive me to the nighttime. If you don't kill for the pain, you gotta wade into the water. You gotta learn to live again and reach out for the
I hate doing videos, I must admit, I loathe doing them. They're unfortunately a necessary evil to sell your commodity, especially in Europe with TV and stuff. Some of them I've been lucky enough to work with some good people, but I really don't like videos very much.
If you're talking about selling records, it's almost more necessary to make the video than to do the tour, isn't it?
Yeah, it's, you know, if you don't do it, the record company kill you. So you have to do it, and I moan every time I have to do it. Having said that, again, there have been some good videos, but I think it's only necessary sometimes when a video can enhance the lyric of a song. Just having to do one every time is an absolute pain.
It's over. The shadow knows that shadow is me. I won't fall and cause you trouble. Oh, that's the last thing I'll ever do. But before I leave your life completely, tell me who wears this
shoe. So you're compromising, do you think?
I am a bit, yes. And I don't like that. I never, when I first became successful in the early 70s, I was used to set trends by not taking singles off albums, by doing separate singles, by doing two tracks on the B-side, longer singles. I mean, in America, when we first started out, there was never a five-minute single, and we kind of changed that for the good, I think. But if you were to hit the nail on the head, you probably just did. I'm fed up with, you know, compromising and following trends rather than, you know, trying to set them again. And after 20 years, you think, oh, come on, just take a little time, step back, and have a look. I mean, it's obviously never going to be like it was in the early 70s, where if you're on a roll, you can set trends, you know, you can do exactly what you like because people will just play things anyway. But I think it's a fair assessment.
If it's becoming a bit of a drudge, you don't need to do it. Why do you do it?
Well, I mean, I'm not painting a picture of doom and gloom. I mean, I do like it. It's just that I think it's necessary to take stock of one's career after such a long time and say, no, which direction do I move in next? Rather than just carry on and doing it. I think if I carried on and did what I do now all the time, I'd get bored to tears. I'm just thinking it's a necessary time now in my life to take stock of things musically. I've taken stock of them personally, and now I want to do that musically. I don't usually get fed up with playing live. And that is, because when you do something live, things change every night. When you're making a record, it's kind of like doing an examination at school, and you can, but only thing different to that is you can rectify it and go over it time and time again. So the pleasure in playing live will always be there.
To love. Now I'm too afraid to wind up out of love. Stop and tell me I'm satisfied. To the plants to make me want to fall apart. I guess this kind of thing just in your blood. You are the cat you're calling up my love. I ain't no bugle beat the knee in the pit. If I take a bottle beat, that's a kind of quick. And I don't want to go out with you like that.
Elton John's case against the Sun was due to be heard today, but the paper and the pop star reached an out-of-court settlement at the last minute.
You were given some appalling treatment by the young press in Britain. As you think back on that, I mean, it must have put an enormous strain on you.
It did. I couldn't really believe that year was a particularly bad year. I don't know what planet was in alignment with the other, but it just was not very good. It placed an enormous strain on myself, but also my family and people that, you know, work for me on a day-to-day basis, because one could hide behind one's brick wall and not come out for a while, whereas everyone who went to work every day had the harassment of people saying, oh, see what he's done, or see what they're saying about it, so and so. So in that respect, I was more fortunate than the people around me. But it was embarrassing. I mean, God, it carried on for a long time. But the people around me and the people in England really were very supportive, everywhere actually, not just in England. I was just determined, you know, to prove that it was a lie. And I didn't know it would take so much time. The law works very slowly. But the outcome was worth it. It didn't make me bitter. It made me stronger. And it just proved a point. And I, you know, when I did the settlement with the newspaper, I said, like, let's get on with one's life now. And, you know, it's no point in being bitter. I see too many bitter people in this business when they have no reason to be.
We still sit at separate tables, and we sleep at different heights. And the warm wind in the palm trees hasn't helped to change our minds. It was the lure of the tropics that I thought might heal the scars of a love burned out by silence in a marriage minus heart.
Valentine's Day, 1984. Elton John causes world headlines as the famous bachelor marries his former sound engineer, German-born Renata Blau, at St. Mark's Anglican Church in Sydney's Darling Point. Critics said the marriage couldn't last, and now they've been proved right. Today, Elton announced that he and Renata have been living apart for 6 months.
The fact that you didn't become bitter would amaze many people, because the stories about the toy boys, rent boys, and what have you. Did that destroy your marriage?
No, I don't think so. My marriage was not on particularly good grounds then, but Renata was incredibly supportive when that happened. And one of the reasons I didn't take it into court and settled out of court is that when the settlement came through, really all I wanted was the front page apology, and I got a very heavy financial settlement too. But the principle was that I got the front page apology, because usually they're shoved under the bingo result. And she was very supportive during that. But no, as I said before, it was a time that year seemed to be going crazy. I mean, my marriage was on very shaky grounds. And then that happened. And then I just got over the voice thing. It seemed one thing after another. But she is an incredible lady. She was very supportive. And I didn't want to put her through standing up in court, which she wants. She said, I'd do that for you anytime. And I just thought, right, let's just get on with our lives now. Not, you know, we were coming to the end of our marriage, and you can't ask any more of a partner than that sort of loyalty, really.
As a team, new XLO Liquid Scourer and XLO Sponge are really cleaning up. A beautiful performance. XLO. What a team.
Hot, hot chicken.
A cool, cool Coke.
For just $3, a summertime treat.
The chicken and Coke just can't be beat.
Sip it cool. Eat it hot.
The chicken and Coke. At your favorite.
The thing about being a pick-a-berry woman is knowing which pick-a-berry to pick.
Pick-a-berry woman, fresh colors every season.
For people with a lot of gear to cart around, we've built the very accommodating new-look Nissan Sentra Sport Wagon. Spirited charger, powered by a new 1.4 or 1.6 multi-valve engine.
You really got me.
And stylish enough for any night on the town. Nissan, built for the most important race of all, the human race.
Here is a country that can't be beat. It's on the faces of the people you meet. It's in the way that we make each day a treat. It's in the ice cream that
we
all
eat. Trumpet.
Try new mint trumpet. Delicious tip-top mint ice cream topped with chocolate and chocolate chips.
You can't beat a trumpet. You can't beat a trumpet. You can't beat a trumpet.
Yellow.
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 Kodak Brilliant Yellow.
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 Kodak is color.
Monday in Home and Away.
What if we get caught?
We won't.
Another harebrained idea from the dropouts.
I can't think what they possibly wanted for.
But they've been caught out.
How did you guess?
Again.
Who else around here has the mentality of a two-year-old?
They're not the only ones.
I know what really happened between you and Ruth. And you're damn lucky if I don't knock your block off.
Have Frank's indiscretions caught up with him? Has Ross's dream come to an end?
Oh, I am going to miss him now.
Home and Away, 6 o'clock Monday, me only too. On 3.
Goodbye, Norma Jean. Though I never knew what all that happened, rest to hold yourself and those around you call. Crawled out of the woodwork and they whispered into your brain. They said you are the treadmill and they made you change your name. It seems to me you lived your life like a candle in the wind, never knowing who to cling to when the rain set in. I would have liked to have known you, but I was just a kid. Your candle burned out long before.
Probably nobody deserved the treatment you got, but as you reflect back on it, the flamboyance, the talk of your bisexuality and everything, do you sometimes think, if only I hadn't almost come out of the closet, I wouldn't have invited all this?
Yeah, but that was in 1976, and this was happening 11 years later. Now, I have no regrets about that. It's a personal thing, it's a personal choice of, for each individual to admit it or to keep it to themselves. I just was asked a question by Rolling Stone magazine and I answered it and I felt very comfortable in answering it. Other people, you know, it's a much harder thing for them to handle. They don't want to be known. I don't regret that at all. But, you know, when you are flamboyant and when you are willing to make those sort of statements, you have to expect sometimes sarcastic remarks and things in your newspaper. That's only, and I've had those before. I mean, when you're chairman of a football club and you said that in the newspaper and you go and sit in front of 20,000 people and they're very funny football crowds and you have to sit there, you know, you really have, if you don't like the heat, get out of the kitchen. It's kind of one of those things. So I don't really think it's had any effect on my popularity, although maybe in America a little with the Bible Belt. But I don't regret it. But on the other hand, if I'm out in the street and people, you know, follow me around, photographers and that, that's part and parcel of it. You can't, you know, it's no good. I don't travel around with bodyguards shoving people out of the way. No pictures, no pictures. This is a public business you're in, and that's, you know, you have to accept that. I really get annoyed when you see certain people traveling around with bodyguards just pushing people out of the way. That's basically rudeness and arrogance, and to taken to the point of despicability.
It seemed, though, that this obsession with your homosexuality overtook the interest in your music.
So yeah, I would agree with that, yeah. Well, I'm not... I honestly don't know why, but I don't know. It did, actually. I mean, I think we've made some pretty good songs on albums, but when everybody writes about me now, it's still in England, it's still about the hair transplant, the high-heeled shoes, the glasses, the marriage, and it's never... You get to the point now where I don't do press interviews anymore in England, or mostly anywhere, because all they want to find out about is your public life and the image that you've created. I suppose that's part of the prize of fame. I mean, nobody ever really asks Liza Minnelli, what she's doing is usually about, are you not drinking anymore or whatever. It doesn't bother me. As long as people still buy the records and come to the concerts, you know, you can't really ask for much more than that.
Hey,
They come to your concerts now, and the parody, the self-parody, has gone, hasn't it? The high heels.
I carried it much too far.
Did you actually think you went over the top?
Oh, yes. Towards the end, yes. And on the tour I did with the Melbourne Symphony Orchestra, when I dressed up for the second half in the kind of wig and it made one feel that I was going to go and play with an orchestra. But the costumes and the first part of the show were totally ridiculous, and I realised halfway through the tour that you know, this was the last time I was going to do anything like that. I carried on a bit too far, but I enjoyed it so much when I started off, and I think that had an effect on the popularity of people's regard to my music. I think they said, oh, how can it possibly be good music when it's dressed like that? See their point sometimes on reflection. And when I sold all my stuff at Sotheby's and you know, the costumes and things like that, it did bring a smile to my face and very fond memories. But yes, I would say it went on too long. And now you get to a certain point in your life and you don't really want to carry that on. And now I feel much more comfortable just standing up there in a suit. I mean, I still wear bright clothes on stage. I'm not a denims person. But that's just me, as some other people are.
Is this a midlife crisis?
No, it's not a crisis at all. I'm very happy with my life. Yeah. I think the midlife crisis happened when the sun thing happened in England. That was... I don't believe in the term midlife crisis. In a career, you can get fed up with what you've done and fed up with some of the songs you've written. Personally-wise, I'm fine. I would say that there's not a crisis with the music. It's just that I want to take stock and do something a little fresher rather than, you know, I'm going over old ground again, I know. But that, if there is a crisis, that would be the only crisis that's around. I just don't want to do this sort of album anymore. But as far as my life goes, I'm very happy. The last 2 years have been, they've been very, very hard, but they've taught me a lot, and I think they put my priorities in a better perspective.
We're going to see a political Elton John. This tends to happen. You're going to start making statements and what have you. I notice with Durban Deep, for example, which is a timely comment. Well,
we've always made political statements in our songs. It's just that probably, I think when Bernie Taupin writes the lyrics, I often got frustrated that because some of his songs were quite heavily politically motivated and had covered a lot of other touchy subjects, that my wearing those clothes took the edge off the statement that he was making in the songs. So, I mean, I think he got a little frustrated about that, because when you're trying to make a political statement, or you're trying to say something and say, listen, look at this situation, whatever, and I come on in a sort of negligee and a wig, it does sort of it doesn't really go hand in hand with it. So, and that is poor Bernie. I mean, I feel sorry for some of the stuff that he's written and that I've recorded when I've done it on stage. People say, well, I mean, but we've lasted 22 years. It's our 22nd year together. But even on Far as Yellow Brick Road, if you look at Bernie's lyrics, there's always something to say. Even going back to the Elton John album, it's just that maybe because of what I've done, what I wore, that's taken a bit of edge off people's ideas about his lyric.
What do I say when it's all over? The hardest word.
Across the southern oceans in the world's toughest yacht from the start line, and Mars is with them all the way. There's all the goodness of milk, glucose, malt, and thick, thick chocolate in Mars. That's why Mars is the official snack food of the Round the World Yacht Race.
Off with Kiwi Rock, 25 years of NZ's best with Ray Columbus. Jenny Morris.
Body and soul.
Split Ends.
I just spent 6 months in Leaky
Boat. Dave Dobbin.
I love you like I should.
And When the Cat's Away.
What we need is a great big melting pot.
Over 30 artists together for the first time on double CD and cassette. Kiwi Rock. Rock.
Most homes have an ordinary low-pressure hot water cylinder. You can get a reminder any time you take a shower. But when you replace it with a mains pressure system from Reed, when your old cylinder fails, tell your plumber, mains pressure from Reed. It takes the hour out of your shower.
Free Sports Sunday, presented by WINS, features sumo wrestling, kayaking, water skiing, motor racing, snooker, and polo. All on Free Sports Sunday, presented by WINS.
If you use this
It won't get like that. But if it has, use this, followed by that, then this, and finally that. However, if you use this first, you would have never needed that. Get it?
The good sports are all on Three Sports Sunday, presented by Wins.
Is it the Colonel's secret blend of 11 herbs and spices? Is it the way it's cooked? Whatever it is, when you lift the lid on a box of Kentucky Fried Chicken, people can't wait to dive in.
Sunday night, an extraordinary special comes to Three.
Love Conquers All.
Presented by Bruce Boxleitner, an amazing collection of stories that could never happen in real life, but did.
It was the most miraculous thing you wanted to see.
Told by the people who lived them. Five true love stories, all with surprise endings.
It was probably the most exciting moment in my whole entire life.
Take a heartwarming journey down the road to true love. Love with a twist. 7:30 Sunday, only on Three.
How do you explain your longevity? It's your concert. There are kids there who were not even born when you were
starting. No, it's wonderful. It's great.
And then they recognize the first few notes, and they know what it is, and they know the words.
I find that incredible, and I find it very, very rewarding. I mean, I've never been the sort of artist that's been screamed at. I've never been, you know, when artists first started, like the Beatles or anything like that, because I'm not the physical sort of shape or have the features to be screamed at, maybe in horror. I think the success of any longevity is a song. If a song's a good song and you have the ability to write songs and record them, and it is very, very rewarding to look in an audience which is older than you, same age, younger, and then much younger, to think that your music, when I write a song or write a piece of music, I want it to be heard or appreciated by as many people as possible. So that's, you know, when you get reviews in the papers, they said, well, it was hardly a teeny bopper audience. I kind of thank that, because I mean that means you've got a faddish audience, and that's always a danger sign to have all your eggs in one basket. And I have never had my eggs all in one basket, and I never will. So I like too many sorts of music too much. So it's wonderful to see these kids. And I was playing Tiny Dancer last night, and there's a kid of about 8 or 9 in the front, two kids, and they knew the words. I thought, good God, it's ridiculous. It brings a smile to your face.
I've always said one's enough to love. Now I hear you bragging one is not enough. Well, someone told me on a satisfied, you got plans to make me want to. I guess this kind of thing just in your blood, but you won't catch me coming up, my love. I ain't no puzzle piece that needs to fit. If it takes more than me, let's call it quits. Cause I don't wanna go on to you like that. Don't wanna be a feather in your cap. I just don't wanna tell you, honey, I ain't mad. But I don't wanna go on to you like that.
You started off by saying that you were sort of contemplating your future and what have you. How long will it go on? Is Elton John going to be an aging rocker?
I think so. It's too far now. I mean, I really do enjoy what I do. I mean, if I painted a bleaker picture at the start of the interview, it's only because I think it's necessary to take stock of yourself. But I think there'll always be a performing Elton John. It's just that I'm going to, you know, have a little bit of time off and then see what the future... It's nice to take 2 years off and sort of see what's going on and what... It's important to always be excited in this business. If you're not excited, then something's wrong, because it is an exciting business and you're very fortunate to be in it. So there will always be records and there will always be performances. I like the performances a lot. So it's just I might not be around for a couple of years, but I'll be there somewhere.
You worked your way through the crisis, if you like, the terrible publicity, the marriage and your throat. Now you need the time.
To enjoy my life, I think, basically. through that time, was hard, and now all I want to do is just enjoy a bit of my free time, spending some time with my friends and my mother. My mother's out here. I haven't really seen her for so long, and we've actually been so close on this trip. And she's with my auntie as well, and that them being on the trip has made the trip really valuable for me, because I spent more time with them in these last three or four weeks than I've probably done in the last 4 or 5 years. And that to say, you have to get your priorities right, and I'd rather make my mother happy than go around the world on another tour, but just by spending time with her. And that's really gotten home to me on this trip. God, it's been so nice to spend time with my mother and my mother's sister.
So no wild parties with Mum around?
No, are you serious? She's unbelievable. No, I think that's where I get my gregariousness from, her. And she's great fun to be with. But it's, you know, you can buy your mother or your parents anything, and they love it, but it's a phone call or actually taking them out to dinner that means much more.
Having just finished his two New Zealand concerts, Elton moves up 13 places on the singles chart.
Of War, Journey for Margaret, the Thursday afternoon movie at 4:10 on 2.
When the big occasion calls for two, now here's one specially bred for roasting and carving. Le Grand Poulet, tender spring...